Yes, Yashmit, you can ask. Wow, all right, I shall come to that. And just let me introduce this. Meanwhile, I'll be taking a short break. So I'll be asking you that thing, right? Just let me begin this. Okay. So children, it is biographical sketches. A biography is an account of the life, activities, and achievements of a particular person. See, biography means a general bio. Bio means a general detailing of a person's birth, parents, place of birth, his childhood, his education, his early school years, where he took his college life, the place, people in his family. Say, if I am Mahatma Gandhi, so a brief detail will be accompanying all these details, yes? And what are my, specific features, if I knew some special skill since my childhood days. So that will also be incorporated in that biography. Basically, it's a detail from birth till death. And in between, whatever the person has become, made, created, got fame. So all these things will be in detail by someone else. I am Mahatma Gandhi and Yashmit Sinha is the, the news correspondent. He took my interview and on the basis of that 4-hour long interview, I told him everything about my life, what he asked. And very shortly, he created a book based on that interview as it was so detailed and it took place in various phases. Maybe it expanded on a 2-day account or maybe 3-day account. Yes, Yashmit. Yeah, Ramayan is quite long saga, right? Yeah, but say the interview was 4-hour long, so you were very precise about on some specific aspect of my personality. Say you only focus in the interview about my, about my views for Indian independence or how India should be or how the Indian constitution should get framed, or maybe if not this, then maybe on my views on the education, right? Maybe my opinion about non-violence. There may be so many areas which you would like to explore about me, but that is not possible in 4-hour long interview, right? So you have highlighted only 2 aspects, either the education or non-violence, or maybe my personal beliefs, my personal likings, ahimsa, or cleanliness, hygiene. There are so many areas. So that can also be a kind of, account of a person's life. But in biography, basically, we include everything, right? So yes, like you said, Mahabharat, right, or Ramayan. So like it is so detailed and long. So maybe to know about someone in such a depth, you need to have time. You need to spend that much of time with that person. What do you think? In future, you also, people will become some famous doctor, some famous scientist. People will take your appointments to, know your research, your interest area. What are your future plans? So, aap aadhe ghante mein to usse finish nahi kar sakte, hai na? And then it always needs time. When you go down the memory lane, you will become middle-aged man and Shruti will become some middle-aged woman, hai na? Successful, settled. So aapko bachpan ki koi cheez sochne ke liye, you will take time. It will not be like, a microwave. You have given instruction and the food is ready. So if you're recalling some past incident, so it's not very easy. It may be also possible that you have a very sharp memory, that you can remember the, each minute detail of some incident of your school life that you have narrated on tip of yours. You're 50-year-old and you're narrating like it just happened yesterday. Seldom it happens, yes or no? So, well, I went into a lot of details. So in short, biography is a kind of a person's life account and it is written by someone else. But when it happens that the person himself is so famous, like Sania Mirza, like Sachin Tendulkar, like Kapil Dev. They themselves took this opportunity to write each and everything about their life and everything associated related to their life by their own, on their own. That becomes autobiography. Hope I am clear with the introduction and the concept of biography is clear. Hana Satya, is it understandable to you?
Yes.
Chalo. Very nice. Very nice. Now, any question? Okay. Yashmit, let me take your homework. So yesterday I gave you some get together invite question. You are going to organize a get together in your house and you are supposed to frame that invitation, that invite for your friends in future tense, I suppose. Or was it future perfect? It was only, no, future progressive it was. I'm forgetting. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, it has to be in future tense. All the four kinds can be used. Okay, now please begin.
December 7, 2021. Dear friends, we planning a group invite on 3rd January 2021 in Chandrasekhar Azad in our house.
Okay. One question. We will be planning after that. What you said? Group invite.
Yes, ma'am.
But it has to be a get together. We are planning a get together. Get together is a kind of, you know, like a snack or a brunch kind. Brunch means what? You have invited your friends. They are in your house. You are offering some, you know, beverage and snacks. And then, uske baad puchna hi nahi hai. All right, continue. I will be, spell that word.
Heartful.
Spell this word. Spelling. H.
H-E-A-R-T-F-U-L-L.
Heartful. Okay. So, but nowhere you mention me. I'm not invited, so I may not appreciate this. All right, well, just a joke on a lighter note. Yes. So, yeah, it's a good invite. And this way you can always draft an e-group invite or maybe some other kind of movie invite or maybe some kind of party invite to your friends, right? Through emails, through posters, through WhatsApp. All right. So, yeah, coming back to a good attempt, Ashmit. Yashmit. So now coming back to the biographical sketches, I would like any one of you to, Shruti, can you please read from the beginning after the definition ends?
Biography is an account of the life, activities, and achievements of a particular person. It gives information about an individual's personal life, such as person's full name, education, occupation and like other activities. Guidelines for writing a biography. The following guidelines will be helpful while writing a biographical sketch. Collect basic information about the person. Full name, date, place of birth, family background. Mention achievements and various personal influences which affected the person's life. A draft is prepared after all the information is collected. The various facts and the story about the person's life is presented in a
chronological
order, so that we give the clear picture of all that happened from the beginning to the present. While writing a biographical sketch, the information provided by the person or any other source should be verified. The following table will give information about the life of Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, the 11th President of India from 2002 to 2007. Questions. When and where was he born?
Okay, wait. So till here, I believe that what does the bullet say? Satya, can you summarize what Shruti has read? Just use few words and try to summarize that what these bullet points say. Right. So can you summarize? If yes, then start. No. This I'm not asking. I'm asking you to explain what Shruti has read. She has read. That's why I cannot understand. Understood is past form. I am Zinda. You are also. You do not want to? Then ask me. All right. So the summary can be? Okay. Let me crack. I rejoin myself. And you just, maybe. To you, it may be cracking, but other students does not that. I think my voice is okay. They can all make meaning out of it. Anyway, sir, that's okay. Thank you, Shruti and Yashmit, for the same. Okay, Satya, not an issue. I may do the thing. I think we need to have some basic information about the person's life, who that person is, what is his DOB, his birthplace, family background. Right, and then you need to include the other achievements of that person's life that has created an impact on the person's life, right? And after all this kind of things are with you, now you can move ahead for preparing a draft. All right, so the draft can be something like in which the facts and the story about the person's life. Stories means what are the different opinions, what are the different beliefs of people about that person, whoever has come in touch with him, or maybe who has, spent a time, a year, a period, a phase with that person. So those all things can be taken into account. Now the last point says, while writing a biographical sketch, the info provided by the person or any other source should be verified. Whatever information we are, trying to include in that biography, that has to be verified. Verified means after complete scrutiny, it has to be taken into account. We cannot write something like, if I want to know if Gandhiji was studious or not, I will simply not depend on some interview, right? I may try to get in contact with the native place, with the school, right? I may go myself in person, can check. So there are a number of things. After all these kinds of steps, we only type or include that information, right? So in my next lecture, I'll be covering up the table and we shall be solving more examples. That's all for today. Hope this is understood. Nod your head. Yeah, Satya. This one, biography. Just now, give me 2-3 minutes. Let them go. Bell is already rung, right? Stay patient. I shall be sharing. You can watch it. Thank you. Have a good day.